Hello, welcome to another Music Theory video. I'm David Farrell. Today's video is on secondary leading tone chords. We're going to be introducing a new type of chromatic chord. We're going to talk all about what it is, how we see it in music, how we use it in our composition. Let's get right into it today. Secondary leading tone chords are going to be very similar to secondary dominant chords. Our previous video talked about secondary dominance, and if you need to review that, you can go back and watch that video again. Secondary leading tone chords do a lot of the same things. They're always going to be diminished triads or diminished seventh chords. And just like our secondary dominants, these chords borrow a leading tone chord from another key, and usually the key of a diatonic triad. Again, this should sound really familiar because it is very similar to the way secondary dominant chords work. But instead of borrowing a five chord, a dominant chord, from another key, we're borrowing the leading tone chord from another key. We're borrowing the seven chord, okay? And so instead of looking for major triads, which most five chords are, we're looking for diminished chords, which is how most seven chords function. Just like our secondary dominants, our secondary leading tone chords do not present a full change of key. Instead, they present a momentary tonicization of another chord. And we remember that term from the last video. We're just pretending that a different chord is the tonic for a brief moment. So if we are borrowing a seven chord, right, we know that there are two different types of seventh chords we can find on the scale degree seven. Those are fully and half diminished seven chords. Which ones should we expect to see? Well, secondary leading tone chords can be either fully or half diminished seventh chords. And so when we look at music and we try to analyze, or when we compose, we should expect to encounter both of these. However, fully diminished seventh chords are used much more frequently in music than half diminished seventh chords. If you see a secondary leading tone chord and it is a seventh chord, it is most frequently going to be a fully diminished seventh chord. And you might say, well, we probably only use those to tonicize minor triads because minor keys have fully diminished seventh chords in them. Major keys tend to have half diminished seventh chords. But I am telling you that even when we tonicize major triads, we frequently will use a fully diminished seventh chord as our secondary leading tone, despite the fact that they're not even used in that major key. Yes, it's a little bit counterintuitive, right? We're borrowing from the key of our dominant, but we're borrowing a chord that doesn't really belong to that key, which is pretty weird. But this is how it is. This is what we tend to find in music. And so we just want to be ready for that, okay? So most of our borrowed chords are going to be fully diminished seventh chords. That's the thing we're looking for, even if they aren't technically from that major key we're borrowing from. Our process for identifying a secondary leading tone chord is pretty similar to the way we identify secondary dominants. And we just have to be careful not to confuse these two chords, because we tend to see them both with a bit of regularity, right? First things first, is the chord chromatic, right? If it's a diatonic chord, then it is probably not going to be a secondary leading tone chord. But if we have pitches from outside the key signature, it might be a secondary leading tone chord. Next, we have to think about the quality of the chord. Is the chord a diminished triad or a diminished seventh chord? If it is not one of those things, it can't really be a secondary leading tone chord. But if it is, well, the odds are that we could have a secondary leading tone chord. And to identify which secondary leading tone chord we have to ask ourselves, what diatonic chord's root is a half step above the root of this chord? Or we can say to ourselves, right, this chord is seven of what? So if we see an A sharp fully diminished seventh chord, well, A sharp is a half step below B. A sharp is the leading tone to B, so we might be tonicizing B. If we see a C sharp fully diminished seventh chord, C-sharp is the leading tone of D, and so we might be tonicizing D with a diminished chord. Let's look at a simple progression here that has 1 and 5 and 1 in our key of D major, but in the middle we see a chromatic chord there. I know it's chromatic because it has two pitches that are not in my key signature for D major. It has a G-sharp, and it has an F natural. And so the first thing I've already answered that question, is the chord chromatic? Yes, it's got a G sharp and an F natural in it. Is the chord a diminished triad or seventh chord? Well, G sharp, B, D, F natural is how we would stack this in thirds. G sharp B D is a diminished triad, and F natural is a diminished seventh above G sharp. So yeah, this is a fully diminished seventh chord. So this is likely a secondary leading tone chord. The last question, G sharp is seven of what? What diatonic chord's root is a half step above G sharp? Well, G sharp is the leading tone of A here. And so that means we're tonicizing A, which is five in this key. I will label this then seven, fully diminished seven of five. Notice I'll use the same slash notation that I used for my secondary dominants. This is a seven, fully diminished seven, but it's not the diatonic one from D major. No. It is borrowed. It is borrowed from the key of five, from the key of A. And again, notice that technically this one is almost more borrowed from A minor. It's got that F natural that isn't a part of the key of A. We're borrowing a fully diminished seven chord. This is the most common way to borrow. Again, even though that fully diminished seventh chord isn't a part of A major, it's the one that we're going to see most frequently. This is what we're looking for when we look at secondary leading tone chords. Is the chord chromatic? If it is it a diminished triad or seventh chord? The answer to that is yes, we have likely have a secondary leading tone chord, and we'll want to ask, what are we tonicizing? The root of our leading tone chord is the seven of what? That'll help us label our chord. Just be sure that you answer question two carefully when we do this. Fully diminished seventh chords have a lot of funky intervals in them, right? Diminished fifths and diminished sevenths. And sometimes we can look at a messy chromatic chord, like the one I've written here, and say, oh yeah, look at all those accidentals, and there's a G sharp in there. This must be a secondary leading tone chord. I'll label it 7 of 5. But be sure to take the time to actually analyze your intervals. We can look at this chord and say, oh yeah, this is probably a secondary leading tone chord, but if we start to spell it out, we realize that the chord is E, G sharp, B flat, and D. And there really isn't any way for us to form a diminished triad in there. This is not a secondary leading tone chord. This is some other chromatic sonority. So take your time and do your analysis. Make sure you are convinced of the intervals and you know we've got a diminished chord before you label it as a secondary leading tone chord. Okay? Just as we did with dominants, we'll take a quick peek at all the different leading tone chords we can find in a major and a minor key. Here is our D major scale with all its diatonic triads, 1 through 7, and their harmonizations with leading tone chords. One is harmonized above it by its half diminished diatonic seventh chord, 7 half diminished 7. And here we can see the rest. The leading tone chord of 2, a D sharp, fully diminished seventh chord. I've used the frequently found fully diminished seventh chords for all of these. Tonicizing 3, tonicizing F sharp, is an E sharp fully diminished chord. E sharp, G sharp, B, and D. Tonicizing G major, our 4 chord, is an F sharp fully diminished seventh chord. Tonicizing 5, our A major triad, is a G sharp fully diminished seventh chord. And tonicizing 6, B minor, is our A sharp leading tone chord. A sharp, C sharp, E, and G, a fully diminished seventh chord on A sharp. Just like with our dominants, we don't really borrow from the keys of diminished triads, and so we're not tonicizing seven diminished. And just a note, lots of accidentals in these chords, right? A little bit more than many of our secondary dominants. Secondary leading tone chords, again, we have to watch out for our intervals, our diminished fifths, our diminished sevenths, and so do pay close attention to what accidentals you'll need when you're spelling these chords in your own writing. We can look quickly at the same chords in minor. Here is D minor with its leading tone chords. We start with our tonic triad and the fully diminished seventh chord that we see in the D minor scale, C sharp, fully diminished seven. Two, a diminished triad, does not frequently get tonicized. We know diminished triads not frequently tonicized. Three, F major with its tonicization with an E fully diminished seventh chord, seven fully diminished seven of three. 4, G minor being tonicized, again with an F sharp fully diminished seventh chord. Our 5 chord here, A major being tonicized again with a G sharp fully diminished seventh chord. And 6, B flat being tonicized with an A fully diminished seventh chord, A, C, E flat, and G flat. Seven, of course, we know, another diminished triad, not being tonicized terribly frequently. And so this gives us a quick rundown of the different leading tone chords, both the diatonic and all the different secondary chromatic leading tone chords that we might find in minor keys. I'll say it one more time, lots of different accidentals that we see, lots of intervals. Be careful with these chords. Make sure you feel confident about spelling your diminished intervals when you're writing and identifying these chords. And so we'll finish our talk by talking about part writing, how to use these chords in context. Generally, our secondary leading tone chords are going to be treated like regular leading tone chords, okay? They're going to be treated just like we would normally resolve a seven fully diminished seven chord. Our leading tone will typically resolve up, our seventh will typically resolve down. One thing we want to watch out for, any 7-to-1 is unequal fifths with the bass. This is a thing that we can encounter very, very easily here. And if we look at our first example, I've highlighted it here, because we've got our secondary leading tone, a G sharp in the bass, and I did resolve it up by step to A, the root of my 5 chord. The seventh of my diminished seventh chord is F natural, G sharp, B, D, F natural. F natural is the seventh, and I resolve that down by step to E. I also want to be careful with my soprano note here, because this is the diminished fifth above my bass. My bass is singing G sharp, my soprano is singing D, and I don't want to resolve that diminished fifth to a perfect fifth via parallel motion, right? This would be unequal fifths. I might be thinking, oh, D could step up to E, and that's a great resolution, but I would then be resolving G sharp to D up to A and E, you know, and that would be unequal fifths. This is a really easy voice leading trick to fall into, and so be careful with your seven resolutions here. I do have unequal fifths in my middle voices. As long as unequal fifths aren't with the bass, we can live with them, okay? And this one, in this particular chord, I don't really want to resolve the B in my tenor up to C sharp. I'd be doubling the leading tone, which is something I don't care to do. Just like in our secondary dominance, if we resolve to another seventh chord, we may have our leading tone resolve chromatically down. Here I've resolved an inverted version of the same chord, a G-sharp fully diminished seventh chord to a 5 chord, but instead I resolved it to 5-6-5. And notice that my G-sharp resolves down chromatically to a G natural to become the seventh of that next chord, rather than resolving up by step to A. This is a common exception to our leading tone resolves up rule. When we resolve from one secondary chord to another seventh chord, this stepwise resolution here is quite nice. And of course, we can resolve here to a cadential 6-4 chord as well. We can see the voice leading works out quite nicely. My leading tone in the bass resolves up. My seventh does eventually resolve down to E, though it wanders up to an F natural in the cadential 6-4 before moving down by step. And I didn't have to even mask unequal fifths between my G sharp and D because my D resolved down by steps. All in all, lovely voice leading using our secondary leading tone chords. All we have to do is just remember the typical things we already know about resolving seventh chords and resolving leading tones, and we should be in really good shape with these. That is all for this video on secondary leading tone chords. In this video, we talked about this new family of chromatic chords, very closely related to the secondary dominance that we've already studied. We talked about what makes a chord a secondary leading tone chord, how to identify it in our analysis, and how to use it in our composition. If you have questions, bring them to class. Otherwise, enjoy the rest of your day. Thanks a lot for watching.